What's up, trade hackers? Welcome to today's update. Today's Thursday, March 19th. S&P is trying to make a little bit of a rally, up about 13 points at the moment. We've got about 20 minutes left until the cash market closes. The leader of the pack, though, is the Russell, up almost 6%, and then the Nasdaq's up over 2.5%. So the market is trying to rebound a little bit, and the big mover of today is oil. Look at CL, up 26%. So that's music to our ears for a position that we have in oil. We're trying to get a little bit of a bounce back in oil before we kind of finish adjusting that position. So good bounce in oil. Hopefully we get a little bit more upside action tomorrow, but we will see. Gold and silver. Gold's pretty flat. Silver's up 3%. Natty gas up 3.5%. A big move in wheat, up 5%. We added a position in wheat today, sold some premium. Premium's nice and juicy in there, just like everything else, but added a piece in wheat to just diversify outside of your typical stocks and bonds. So I like to layer in a few of those uncorrelated assets just to keep things a little bit more diversified. Checking out some of the other stocks here, seeing what they're doing. Broadcom up 19%. CMG, Chipotle up 15%. See what some of these other big movers. Delta Airlines continues to slide down 8%. Let's see what else we got here. What else is moving big towards the end of the day? Lyft and Uber up big. They've just been on a downhill slide, but Lyft up about 29% today. I guess people are deciding they want to go out and hail some ride shares. Let's see what else we got here. Tesla up big, up 18%, getting a little bit of a bounce there. And Uber up even more than Lyft, up 37%. And that's it. Wynn's actually getting a bounce here. The casino's getting a little bit of a bounce. So that's what's going on in the stocks. So what did we do today? Well, we closed out, I mentioned wheat. We also closed out a double calendar that we had in SPX. Nice winner for over $2,200 per contract in just 6 days. So that was cool. If we take a look at SPX. Now, what do I think going forward? I think tomorrow we get a pretty sizable bounce higher. I mean, we've just been on this parabolic, you know, downward move. At some point, we got to get a little bounce. Now, there's nothing that says this thing can't get hammered and continue. You know, who knows what kind of news will come out tomorrow, but I really think we're due for a little bit of a bounce up into this range here. In fact, I'll show you guys one thing that I did, and this wasn't an alert or anything, and this is not how I typically trade, but every once in a while I like to take a little shot. And so what I did is I just bought a upside bullish butterfly in SPX. And so basically what I did, price was trading down around here earlier. It's come up to about right here now. And these options actually expire in the AM tomorrow morning. So if you go to the trade tab, you see there's 0 days to expiration, but the expiration, it's not what price they end at the end of today. It's the set price that they open up at after all the stocks open in the morning. So whatever that price is what that will expire at. Now remember, this is SPX, so I don't have to worry about assignment or anything like that. It just settles to cash. And so what I did is I'm just taking a little upside shot. And I pinpointed this, the peak of it is at 2,500 on SPX. And you know, that's over $4,000. Now there's almost zero chance it's gonna hit that peak by any, and that's not what I'm looking for. But if it goes, and this is a 100-point range, you know, so I'm just looking for a little upside movement overnight so it opens up in the morning. If it hits right around 25, that's ideal, but anywhere in this range, you know, I could book $1,000, $2,000, $3,000, and I'm risking about $500, about $530 to be exact is my max risk. So it stays here, goes down, I lose $530, but I've got this about 100-point range. If it does move to the upside, which is my little shot that I'm taking to the upside, could be a nice winner. So again, this is not my bread and butter. This is not how I suggest that you trade. Just thought I'd share this because every once in a while I like to take a little shot, make things interesting, have a little fun, and do something crazy. So I'll see where that one ends up. Everybody have a great evening. We'll talk to you tomorrow.